This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. This is video one of solving equations with decimals. And so we'll be doing these three problems on this video. So here's the first one. So this is similar to a problem without decimals. Notice the coefficient of x is 1. So the easiest way to do this is to simply add 3.2 to both sides to isolate the x. We're going to add 3.2, and we'll be able to solve for x. So x is, okay, and then we add over here. And remember, I had to line up the decimal points. That's important when you're adding decimals. So this will be 9.0. And so that's our answer. It looks like 9.0. Now, normally, how would you write that? You would just write x equals 9. In fact, I think I will take that off. Okay, now we should always check our answer just to make sure. So the original equation is x minus 3.2 equals 5.8, and we're going to plug in 9 for x. So we plug in 9 for x, and then we're going to simplify that. Now, how do we do 9 minus 3.2? I'll give you one way to think about it. Think about it as $9 minus $3.20. It's one way of thinking about it. But if you want to go on the side and do your work, what you do is you have to line up decimal points. So if you have 9 minus 3.2, you want to put this extra 0 in here and then subtract. So then you would, however you do your subtraction, there's lots of ways to do it. So we get 5.8. And then the right side's 5.8, so that looks like it's the right answer. So if we were going to write our answer as a solution set, we would put 9 in braces. All right, here's our next problem. Similar, we've got x plus a number equals some other number. So in this case, the simplest thing to do would be to just subtract 1.6 from both sides. Just like if it was x plus 6, you would subtract 6. And I'm going to line up decimal points. And I gave you a problem where it wasn't too difficult lining up decimal points here. And so we get x equals, and let's do this, arithmetic over here is pretty easy, 3.1. So let's check it. So we're going to put in 3.1 for x. And add, and again, you can go over on the side and do your addition. Over here, you could say, well, 3.1 plus 1.6, that's 4.7. So this adds up to 4.7 over here. And the right-hand side is 4.7. So since we got the same number on both sides, this is the correct answer. And writing it in solution set notation, we would put 3.1 in a solution set. So far, pretty basic. That's why this is the first video. Okay, here's one that's a little bit trickier. We've got x plus 2.31 equals 8. So we would subtract 2.31, but over here you don't see a decimal. So on the other side, you got to be careful. You need to line up the decimal. Remember, when you see an 8, you could think of the decimal point right after the whole number. So I'm going to write this as minus 2.31. So we'll get x equals, and then here's the tricky part. A lot of people make the mistake of saying this is 6.31. But think about it for a minute. If you did $8 minus $2.31, you wouldn't have over $6, right? Because if you subtract $2, you're already down to 6, and then you're going to subtract like 31 more cents, one way of thinking about it. So that's a way of thinking about it, but the way we usually do it is we just put the zeros up here. So you can think of that. Now it looks like $8, but this would work for however many decimal points there are. You want to have the same number of digits showing, makes it simpler to do the subtraction. So now we could go ahead and subtract. Use any method you want for subtract. Since most people do the borrowing method, I'm just going to go ahead and do it that way. 7, and then you put a 10 there, and then you borrow that. 10 there. And so what do we get? 7 minus 2, you get 5, 6, 9. So we get x equals 5.69. So let's check it. So that was the original problem. So we want to plug in 5.69 for x. And let's go over on the side to do our work. So 5.69 plus 2.31 is 8.00, but 8.00 is just 8. And the other side is already simplified. I have 8. So it checks. So this is the correct solution, x equals 5.69. And so if we want to write that using a solution set, we put the 5.69 in the braces. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.